Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Today we will discuss oxides of nitrogen. As we have discussed, nitrogen forms a large number of oxides with variable oxidation state, and that is just possible because of its tendency to form p-pi bonding with the oxygen. Nitrogen has a great tendency to form p-pi multiple bonds with oxygen. That results into a large number of oxides of nitrogen with variable oxidation state. So first oxide is nitrous oxide, N2O. In nitrous oxide, the oxidation state of nitrogen is +1. How it is prepared? It is prepared by heating ammonium nitrate. When ammonium nitrate is heated, as a result, nitrous oxide is formed and water is released. This N2O gas is a colorless, unreactive gas and having a pleasant smell. N2 is a colorless, unreactive and having a pleasant smell. It is also known as a laughing gas because it causes laughter when inhaled in a minor quantity. So if anyone inhaled N2O, nitrous oxide, then it causes laughter, and that is why it is known as a laughing gas. Next is it is neutral compound, neutral oxide. It is a neutral oxide and it reacts with the soda amide to give a azide ion. NaNH2 is a soda amide. So nitrous oxide reacts with soda amide to give azide. This N3 is azide and it is present with sodium, so compound is sodium azide. Actually, azide is N3 negative ion. This is called azide ion. It is a characteristic reaction of nitrous oxide. It reacts with soda amide to give sodium azide. Next is in small quantity, it acts as an anesthetic for minor operations. So for minor operations, it acts as an anesthetic compound. Next is N2O gas decomposes to give nitrogen and oxygen when heated at 873 Kelvin temperature. So at high temperature range of 873 Kelvin, it gives oxygen. So we can say it is supporter of combustion Why? Because it is acting as a source of oxygen. So N2 is a combustible gas. It supports combustion. Why? Because on decomposition it gives oxygen, and combustion is possible in presence of oxygen only. So this is the first oxide, nitrous oxide. Second is nitric oxide. NO or nitric oxide or nitrogen monoxide. The oxidation state is plus 2. That is different from nitrous oxide. In nitrous oxide, oxidation state is plus 1. So how it is prepared? It is prepared by 3 methods. First is first method is catalytic oxidation of ammonia at a temperature range of 1100 Kelvin. Why it is catalytic oxidation? Because the reaction takes place in presence of platinum. As a result, nitric oxide and water is formed. This is the method number 1, catalytic oxidation of ammonia. Method number 2 is by the action of nitric acid on copper. Action of nitric acid on copper. And nitric acid must be here diluted. Concentrated acid does not react with copper, as copper is less reactive than hydrogen. So what will happen? Copper will displace hydrogen. Copper displaces hydrogen, as a result copper nitrate is formed and NO and water is released as a byproduct. This is the method number 2, prepare nitric oxide. We can say it is action of nitric acid on copper. Third, it can be prepared by the reduction of sodium nitrite. Third is reduction of sodium nitrate with ferrous sulfate in presence of sulfuric acid. Reduction of sodium nitrate with ferrous sulfate in presence of sulfuric acid. As a result, ferric sulfate is formed and sodium displaces hydrogen from sulfuric acid. As a result, sodium hydrogen sulfate is formed, NaHSO4. And a gas is released, that is a nitric oxide, NO. Plus a byproduct is a water. So, 4 products are formed: ferric sulfate, sodium hydrogen sulfate, nitric oxide, and water as a byproduct. So, these are the 3 methods to prepare nitric oxide. Next, its properties. Again, it is a colorless gas, and in NO In nitric oxide, 11 valence electrons are present, so it is a odd electron molecule. It is a odd electron molecule and it is a paramagnetic in a nature in a gaseous state. Due to presence of odd electrons, it is paramagnetic in a gaseous state, but it has a different property in solid and a liquid state. In solid and liquid state, it forms a loose dimer in such a way that magnetic effect of both unpaired electrons cancel out with each other, resulting into diamagnetic nature. Right. So in gaseous state it is paramagnetic, but in solid and liquid state it is a diamagnetic. Why it is a diamagnetic? Because it forms a loose dimer, resulting into the cancel out of a magnetic effect of two unpaired electrons. Fifth is, it readily reacts with oxygen to form brown fumes of nitrogen dioxide. It readily reacts with oxygen to give brown fumes of NO2. NO2 is a brown color gas, so brown fumes are observed during the reaction. And sixth, it is thermodynamically unstable. It is thermodynamically unstable, so when heated at a high temperature, heated at a high temperature is of 1373 Kelvin to give a corresponding gases. So at high temperature it dissociates to give nitrogen and oxygen. That is for complete nitric oxide having oxidation state plus 2. Third oxide is N2O3 dinitrogen trioxide. In N2O3, the oxidation state of nitrogen is plus 3. We have discussed plus 1 oxidation state, plus 2 oxidation state oxide. Now third is a compound of nitrogen, oxide of nitrogen having plus 3 oxidation state, that is dinitrogen trioxide. How it is prepared? It is prepared by two methods. It is prepared by cooling equimolar concentration of nitric oxide with nitrogen dioxide. In this reaction, the concentration of both reactant will be same. Equimolar concentration must be there. And temperature range must be below 273 Kelvin.
It is actually a cooling reaction. As a result, dinitrogen trioxide is formed. So this is the first method, by cooling nitric oxide and nitrogen dioxide. Second is it is prepared by the reaction of nitric oxide with nitrogen tetraoxide. Nitric oxide with nitrogen tetraoxide, as a result, two molecules of nitrogen, dinitrogen trioxides are formed. So these are the two preparation methods of trioxide. Now what are its chemical properties? It is blue solid oxide and acidic in nature. Actually, it is an anhydride of nitrous acid. Nitrous acid. So if we hydrolyze the trioxide, we will obtain a nitrous acid. It is a stable only at a room temperature. If its melting point is high, it dissociates to give again NO and NO2. So when its melting point is touched, it gives back to its original reactants NO and NO2. We have prepared by cooling down, and when it is melted down, it gives again back to normal reactants NO and NO2. This is oxide number 3. Fourth, we have nitrogen dioxide having oxidation state of +4. Fourth, we have nitrogen dioxide having oxidation state of +4. So how it is prepared? It is prepared by heating. It is prepared by heating dry crystals of lead nitrate. As a result, lead oxide is formed and oxygen is formed and nitrogen dioxide is formed. It is a characteristic reaction to prepare nitrogen dioxide. So what are its properties? Again, if we observe NO2, it is again odd electron molecule. It is a odd electron molecule, and when this electron absorbs energy and when an electron release energy, it shows color. NO2 is a brown color gas. But actually NO2 exists in a dimer form to form N2O4. Thank you. And when it forms dimer, this odd electron will cancel out. So N2O4 will be colorless, but NO2 is a colored gas, brown color gas. At high temperature, it mainly consists of NO2, and at low temperature, it consists of N2O4. So at a temperature, low temperature 250 Kelvin, NO2 exists as N2O4, but at high temperature it mainly consists of NO2. So at 413 Kelvin mainly NO2 gas exists, but at high temperature it exists of N2O4, right? This is a fourth oxide, nitrogen dioxide. And last we have a nitrogen pentoxide. Dinitrogen pentoxide or nitrogen pentoxide. Oxidation state is +5. How it is prepared? It is prepared by dehydrating concentrated nitric acid with the phosphorus pentoxide. Dehydration of nitric acid with the phosphorus pentoxide. As we have discussed in previous lecture, pentoxide is a water soluble oxide, and it has a great affinity for water, so it removes water from nitric acid. As a result, pentoxide form, and water plus pentoxide form acid, that is phosphoric acid. Actually this pentoxide is colorless again. It is colorless solid, and it is highly acidic in nature due to +5 oxidation state. Higher the oxidation state, higher is the acidic nature. And if any compound is present in its maximum oxidation state, it acts as an oxidizing agent. So N2O5 here is a strong oxidizing agent. It oxidizes iodine to I2O5. That proves that it is a strong oxidizing agent. So total we have 5 oxides. With oxidation number +1, +2, +3, +4 and +5. One question may be asked from oxides of nitrogen. In next video, we will understand the structures of these oxides. Thank you.